Gave y'all front row seats, huh? All right, how we doing, Doubletree? I'm the second person that's going to ask you that tonight. Tell you a little bit about Josh Watts, the person. I'm from a little town called Denham Springs, Louisiana. If you've never heard of it, you could Google it. It's spelled like it sounds. D-E-N-K-K-K-H-A-N Springs. Our city flag is a Polaroid of the Bass Pro. It recently washed away in a flood. I don't know if you heard about that. They asked the six people that graduated. We took a vote. We're just like, you know what? We're good. Let's just call it a day. Being a teenager in Denham Springs is not a whole lot to do that doesn't involve drugs, and I don't do drugs because I'm a good kid. So I was in the Boy Scouts, and at 15 years old, our Boy Scout troop took us to, there was a doctor's land. He lived out here towards Lafayette. I don't know where, it wasn't actually Lafayette. And he had land that he would let us camp on. We pulled up there the first time, and 30 teenage boys got out, and he told us, "Hey man, there's a barn right there, you can build a fire, whatever, just go nuts, man, y'all can't get in trouble out here." You want to bet? You want to bet? So we found it. That's a challenge. We went to this barn, and inside the barn, he had tons of cans of spray paint. So we graffitied the hell out of that barn, of course, like any reasonable pack of 30 teenage boys would do. Because it was dark outside, and as anybody who's ever been a teenage boy knows, when it's dark, you can get away with whatever you're doing. Nobody will ever find out about it. But as the sun came up, we realized the error of our ways and that we were screwed. So we put our 30 brains together, and you know what our solution was? To hide that we graffitied the barn, we burned it to the ground. It worked. They didn't know we graffitied anything. Yeah, and a whole other thing Manny explained. But I've taken that same concept further with me into life. I now have a daughter. She is 15 months old, and her name is Zoe Josephine, but I call her Zojo because that's what I like to call her. She's my favorite person ever, but that doesn't mean that it works out all the time. We were in Target one day, and if you've ever been around a baby, you're just jiggling a landmine all day, just waiting. You're just shaking it like, nah, I'm fine. And that landmine exploded on me in a Target. I don't know what happened. She was a baby, and then she was a horrible, horrible mess. And she was in a Target shopping cart, and she was wearing her mama's favorite outfit for her, but it was covered. Right when I saw that, suddenly in the back of my brain, for some reason, I saw a barn on fire. We rolled outside that Target, and I dumped a bottle of Gatorade on her naked body to clean her off, and I threw that weird onesie into a buggy and pushed it in the woods behind Target because it's your problem now. I'll take my Dad of the Year award now. That has come in handy a few times. I was in a Kohl's shopping for jean vests because I party. And I had Zojo. I don't know why you're laughing at that. It's clear I party. I got pink pants on right now. Are you kidding me? It's a party right here. Zojo was in her stroller, and I was looking at jean vests like, oh, I can put a Metallica patch on this one. I got a 311 one to go right here. And when I turned around, there was a 127-year-old woman who was probably a succubus leaning over the stroller, putting her cold, dead lips next to my beautiful, innocent baby's face. And I thought, I gotta kill this lady. That's it. I gotta round out some face off. That's how this works now. I've never taken martial arts, but if you get near my daughter, it'll look like the end of Roadhouse. I will just, yah. And I was like, well, I gotta, she's 167 years old. She had a good run. And I thought, if she is eating my baby's youth right now, I'm wasting a lot of time thinking about all the ways I'm gonna roundhouse her. And she was just getting closer and closer to my baby's face. This is a true story. A real person did this to a baby she didn't know. And I stuck my hand in between her lips and my daughter's young, innocent face. And she kissed the inside of my hand. And it burned. It burned so bad. It was like Fight Club. I still have it on my hand. But I just picked her face up. And Zoe was still laughing, so I didn't want to freak her out. So I had to be calm. And I said, "What are you doing?" And she looked me right in my face. She said, "I just wanted to kiss it." That's not how you start this. Calling it in is not a good way to start this. And then all of a sudden, in the back of my brain, I saw a barn on fire. And when I went outside, what I saw on fire was her Kia. "Don't ever try to kiss my baby, you strange lady." Don't get the faux leather seats. They go up so quick. So my daughter has a mother that I've been married to for some years now, it would turn out. I thought she was a lady that was just in the house. Turns out we've been together for a long time. And she told me, she said, "Look, we've been spending so much time with Zojo, like we're in shifts. You're awake with baby, I sleep, and then we switch off." She said, "I don't even feel like I know you anymore." So what I did, I read in a magazine this thing that we should do, and I think we should try it. And right then, every instinct in me was like, "You gotta burn everything. It's all gotta go. You gotta burn this house down. You gotta get out of here. You cannot take a quiz this woman found in a magazine to test our relationship." She said, "It's not a quiz, it's fine. Here's what we're gonna do. It's called painting your feelings. We're going separate rooms without thinking about anything, and you just paint what you feel about me, and I'll do the same, and we'll meet up after and we'll talk about it." And my mouth said, "Okay." My brain said, "No! No!" Here's my brain. Before we had my daughter, I always said I was going to name her Baby because I figured she'd be a bad kid. And she'd go to school one day and her teacher would go, "Hey, you go get in the corner." And then like a hero, I'll kick that door and say, "Hey, nobody puts Baby in the corner, right? Because the movie that we all saw, I just nailed it! A fourth grade teacher didn't say, "Wait, did you just kick the door in and scare the hell out of 30 second graders to make a dirty dancer joke? That movie came out in 1987. These kids' parents weren't born yet." So we went into our separate rooms with our paintings. And I brought those paintings here tonight. I'm going to show you guys, if you don't mind listening to what happened to me. We come out, and my wife says, "Okay, I'll go first." And she pulls this out. Right? If you don't believe this is real, this sunflower is now tattooed on my ring finger. And if you listen to the rest of the story, you'll know why I had to do that. So she pulls this out, and instantly I know I got a long night. And she looks at this and she says, "Okay, well, if you look at the sunflower, because it's my favorite flower, and if you remember the Boy Scout summer camp we met at, there was a field of sunflowers there, and we used to always hang out there. And so they just make me think of you, and the sky is blue, because it looks like hope. When I think of our love, that's what I think of, hope. And the stalks of the sunflowers are green and healthy because they're nurtured, just like our love does to me." And I thought, This is bad. This is not, no. And then she said, "I guess just overall, you could say that this painting just, it represents how I feel about you. Safe, loved, and nurtured. So, where's your picture?" And I saw, in the back of my brain, a barn on fire. It was too late. Okay, let me start with I might have misunderstood the assignment. But look, Josh Watts doesn't half-ass anything. I whole-ass everything. So I said, well, all right. If you look real close, it's a lot of fire, blood, and the stink people that are burning slowly and dying are my youth, my joy, and oh, there's my happiness, the one right there. It looks like he still got a little fight in him. And that's a skull because I feel dead inside. And right there on the teeth, written in blood, the words help me because I wish somebody would right now. I love you. We had to talk about this. A lot. We had to pay people to listen to us talk about it. To tell me that I'm wrong in this situation. And I said, well, I'm opening for Emo Phillips tonight, so I gotta get out of here. So far, everything's right for me! But I'm kidding, no, they're still waiting on me. I do have to go back, so I'm gonna have to cut this short. Don't you, you've been great. Thank